Hola amigo, I'm back with another video, and in this one we're going to be going through one of the websites that I use as a template to follow as a guideline for my affiliate websites. So many of you may know that I already follow like Income School, and I also use Franklin Hatchett's kind of methods, but a lot of you don't know exactly the kind of website template that I follow. Like, so the way I construct a post, a website post, there's a few things that I can attribute to the success of the websites that I've built through the copywriting, the techniques and strategies of how I lay the pages out, and the general kind of systematic flow or approach that I take to the websites in the first place. So what we're going to do inside of this video is we're going to look at one of the best sites that I've actually ever come across. And the site, to give you a perspective, has been noted to, at its peak, done I think around 40 to 60k a month. So it's quite a good established website to look at. Many of you may know what the website is before you've even seen it, but I'm going to be showing you exactly what that site is inside of this video. We're going to go through it and break it all down so you can implement those techniques and strategies into your own business. So essentially, we're just going to reverse engineer the site. I hope you enjoy this video, and if you're looking forward to it, then make sure you smash that thumbs up right now. All right, let's get into it. Okay, so the website I wanted to show you was a site called 10beast.com. Some of you may have already heard of this site. It's really interesting because this site came up with only around 10 pages or so initially and was doing over 10,000 per month profit. But at the last reported stage, I believe it was doing somewhere of 40,000 plus in 2018. Now, it has a lot more than 10 pages at this stage. It's now got probably about 40 or 50 pages, which in the grand scheme of things is not a lot, but they went very heavy on the off-page SEO. So a lot of backlinking, a lot of authoritative links, and also a lot of different techniques that you could call black hat in that sense. So one of the techniques they used to use was a scholarship technique. And what that involves is essentially going and creating like a fake scholarship of where they would offer that to local universities or universities around the world, I should say, actually. And those universities will then offer that to students and link back to their article. Now, this is something, a method that he doesn't recommend you use anymore. This guy generally genuinely had an interest in tech, which is why he created this site. He still currently studies. You can see some of his interviews. His name is Lukman on YouTube. He's got an interview with Matt Diggity. If you don't know, you can head over to Matt Diggity's YouTube channel after this video and check that out. But yeah, I've also got his website here where he documented the whole process. It's called nichepie.com. He actually just done a post that will be coming back soon. But what we're going to look at today is the general layout of how he actually does his articles. So what we're going to do is go into one of his old posts. And I really want to show you this because this is exactly the kind of strategy that I use. So in regards to when you're thinking about how I structure my content, well, it's very, very similar to this method. Now, bearing in mind, I am obviously using the Akabadu theme from Income School. So at the same time, I'm combining two different kind of strategies or methods in one. Okay, so I'm doing like a blend of, you know, Income School's approach with this kind of layout in that sense. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to look at a few things that really give different signals on this website that really make it a great high converting site. Now, using this method, I'm currently getting a conversion rate of an average of 20%. Now, that has recently dropped since I've actually been using Income School's Akabadu theme, but there was a few glitches and my site broke when I combined it with something else that I'll explain in a second, but that's for another video. I'll leave that until my income report. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're looking here at the title. The first thing you can see is that they have the keyword right over in the far left hand side, so this gives it a nice level of priority, and then obviously is giving a good strong indicator to search engines that this is the keyword you're trying to optimize your content for. Then we've got top rated mini nano quadcopters. Okay, so this is just what I call a qualifier, and a lot of the time you can find these qualifiers by checking the related searches when you're doing a manual search on Google for a keyword. All right, so every time when they enter into a introduction, they always have something that's based on the desire or the pain of the reader. So in this circumstance, someone doesn't usually have a pain. They're going to be having a desire that they want to have, you know, a drone, and they whatever it is that they want out of a drone, you could touch on that
potential desire. So you can see everyone loves having gadgets, and there are a few ways that are better to spend it a day than flying a drone. Okay, so you know, those people who are reading this already want to have a drone, and now they're giving them that kind of scenario for them to picture it, that they could be flying a drone. Yeah, all right, so they're just building up that rapport in that sense to later then convert them into a sale. All right, so when we go on to the next part, you've got the table of contents here. Now, I was using this plugin, and I've recently stopped using it on my site because it was slowing it down. I am going to get in contact with Income School and see a way that I can implement that into my site without slowing the site down. Now, if you're not using Acabadu Income School's theme and you're just trying to get a general genuine page speed and you're not trying to go for 99 out of 100, then by all means use this plugin. It's brilliant. And what it does is it actually allows you to rank for multiple different terms within one article. So all of these different keywords inside of here, you will also rank for on Google. It's really interesting because it wraps it up all inside of this little box here that's optional for someone to open. But you do start showing up for those terms in Google. And what's even better is when someone's actually searching for something on Google, like this keyword here, it will also give them the hyperlinks to click through and land particularly on these products. So that's quite good in regards to your click-through rate on Google. All right, so the next part, what I usually do is I go straight into this just like them. Now, you might be looking at this and thinking, this looks really good, but what is it? All right, so what this is a table, and it's called AAWP. It's actually a plugin that you can install on your site. Now, I've left the link to that in the description box. It is an affiliate link, so I do get a commission on that. But this product is really good. Now, I would say after checking my metrics over the past 3 months, around 40% of my conversions are coming from this particular tool. All right. Now, what this is a plugin, and it works on Amazon's API. So it's pulling data straight from Amazon. All the prices are updated. You can set that to 4 hours, 24 hours, 2 days, 1 week. Many different options or variations there, and it will update every single day at the specific times that you set, and it will also pull the average customer reviews. So if the reviews go down for this product, it won't make it into the top 10, you see? So what this actually does is pull the top 10 best-selling products within the particular keyword that you type into the tool for this post. And then it gives a nice handy button to Amazon. As you can see, you can click over and it will use the Amazon One link, providing you've set that up, and allow you to go to different countries depending on where you're currently based, located. Okay. Now, the next thing they do is go straight into the in-depth reviews. I don't do that. What I do next is I go into a buyer's guide. Okay. I've actually got a site here that really, you know, shows you the idea of a buyer's guide, what I'm talking about. All right. So what we're going to do is we're going to go in here. And then when we look at this, you can see this is a clear buyer's guide. So how to pick the best dog dryer. You can see they go through durability, storability, high airflow, variable speed, non-heated air, and they explain why you need to look at all these things. Now, if you take that approach, if you were to put, like I'm talking about, you know, this is a buyer's guide, okay? So if you were to put this in, this is a guide to help people to buy, yeah? If you were to put all of this, not this particular thing, you don't copy this, yeah, okay? You do it for the product that you're trying to, you know, create an article on. But if you put all of this information in for people to go through before making a buying decision, you put that all in this section here, yeah, all of that. Well, what's going to happen is when they get to here, they already know kind of what they're looking for. You're educating the reader on how to buy this particular product. Okay, so what you want to do is explain, if it was drones, you might say you look out for airflow, battery life, distance, you know, like how far the thing can go from the control before it dies out. In that sense, it can't get connectivity. So you might say connectivity instead, and then explain and, you know, expand on the abbreviation or the point. Yeah. Okay. Like, why do you need connectivity? Why is it important? What sort of distance would you gauge as an average for a beginner? So on and so forth. Now, the next thing we're going to look at here, what they do really well is they have their H2 titles and then a little bit of text. Now, inside of this text, you're basically explaining the product, like what it's all about. Yeah. So exactly what the product is and why you put it on the list, like what made it good. Okay, then you're going to go through any, if it's a tech product, you're going to go through the features. If it's something to do with a bed or a chair or something like that, you're going to go through the specs. So you're going to put specs and put all the measurements and so on and so forth. Then you're going to go through the pros and cons. Okay, so every single time you want to give nice clear pros and cons. This is exactly, I'll be honest with you, the layout that I have, only with the buyer's guide involved in the middle. But my site looks exactly like this. Okay, I'm giving you the inside information of how my site looks. The only thing I do is my buttons, I've used the same color scheme. If you right click with control and you click inspect, you can get the exact same color schemes that they use. And this is the same color schemes I use. If you type color in there and then you click that and then you go down to the bit, this is, by the way, how it looks on mobile. So you can see how the table converts in mobile. Look, this is why it's so high converting, because when you look at this site, nice image in the top, then some text, and then boom, straight into the top 10 ranking results. And then it's not until the person comes down, me, I would have a buyer's guide here, and then they come after into the detailed reviews of each product. Now their pros and cons is not sitting correct on the mobile view. I would change that. But they also have these boxes as well that are highlighted. And basically, yeah, like I was saying, you can take the colors. If you click that now, that's the color code for this, so you can use it on your site. All right, so if I go back to the normal view, what you will find is that they also have, alongside their H2 titles, some buffers, okay? So qualifiers, again. So for example, if someone's gonna buy something, they might want to easily navigate. You need to make it the best user experience, okay? Because if you have a good user experience, Google's gonna love your content and potentially rank you higher. You want a fast website and you want a great user experience. So the way you achieve that is by, to the right of this, each of these H2 titles, you want to put a nice little qualifier. So for example, if someone was navigating through this site, they can clearly see that this is great for racing. So someone who wants a fast drone, they're probably going to look at this, you know, they're going to come through and go, because everyone skims and scrapes until they find the information that they're looking for. Okay, now if you go down, you can see this one is like plan your flight. Okay, so this one might be one that goes high or something like that. Okay, and then you can see here, this one's great for learning. So if someone is a beginner, they'd probably navigate their way down to here and then start to read in depth about this particular drone. All right, so we can see here each of the features. They've got the pros and cons. And one thing I want to highlight, what they do really well about each of these pros and cons, which I gathered from this website, is that pros and cons are not features. So don't say, you know, blah, 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 it has this and batteries and all of that. They're not looking for that. That's a feature. All right. What we're actually looking for inside of this section is the good stuff and the bad stuff. What's good about this and what's bad about this? And then what I do is, instead of after the features, like if I do have features, I don't have features on like a lot of dog products and things like that, because it's completely irrelevant to a dog collar or something like that. Yeah, so what you would have this on is tech products or like, you know, beds and things like that. Okay, if you were doing something like a dog collar, for example, because I'm in that niche, you would, what I then do is do a conclusion after this. So I will do like a small wrap up. Don't write conclusion, just do a small wrap up, like, you know, in summary, or to wrap this up, this product is blah, 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 and your personal thoughts on what you think of the product. So read your own review and then do a personal wrap up of exactly what's good or bad about this product, and give a few benefits, because that's how people make buying decisions, is based on the benefits of the product, all right? So that's how you sell them. Now, any key areas that you find that are, you know, really good inside of the particular review, you would highlight that with a nice yellow box. Now, if it's something that's negative, I tend to go for a red box. So this site has that across the site, not on this particular page. I think they're not using that technique anymore, but yeah, basically that's what you could do. Now, as you go down, you can see that they have a buyer's guide down here. Yeah, so their buying guide is down at the bottom. So look, why choose? These are the questions you would ask, yeah, or cover for someone. Why choose a mini drone or nano quadcopter? What are the differences between? So these are all the questions someone might have. Tips for mini drones, yeah? And they just go absolutely like ham on the post. Their articles are like 5,000 words, like, and they target these big broad terms like best mini drone, but they go absolutely heavy on backlinks. Now, the guy who owned this site prior to this current owner has sold the site. He sold it for $500,000, which is ridiculous. I think he was only 22 at the time. But it shows you, while studying at uni, you know, you can really make something for yourself and make some extra cash. But if we look at this, you can also see that he's highlighted these negative points inside of the red boxes. So this is quite good for you to implement into your site. Now, I currently do that. If you have any points that you would like to point out and highlight to the reader that's a negative or bad of the site, then you can do that. But don't go crazy with it. You don't want something looking like a bag of Skittles in that sense, okay? It needs to be still professional, still nice, and still easy on the eye and easy to digest, okay? Now, one of the other things that I see a lot of people make a mistake with is the way that they compose their content. As you can see, there are nice 4 to 5 length line paragraphs, and it's nicely even and spaced out, and it's easily digestible. And if we go into mobile, always check your site on mobile as well. You can see that it's nice to digest, all right? So you can see it's nice and easy to read. You've got the nice top 10 there that's getting pulled on the API. And then as you go down, you've got the pros and cons, so on and so forth. I personally, they've got some kind of glitch on that page there. So, you know, make sure your pros and cons are working like stacked or something like that. All right, now, when we look at another thing that's interesting, and I follow exactly this, is the structure of the images. So I always start my articles with an image on the right for my buyer content, okay? Not for my normal informational content. And so buyer keywords are like best this, best that. Now, the reason why this table works so well, and you only want to put this table on buyer keywords. Do not put this table on something that's informational to try and get a commission. If someone's searching, where can I go fishing for the weekend? They don't want to see a top 10 fishing rods list, okay? So someone who's searching what is the best fishing rod for, you know, fishing for eel in that sense, then they're going to want to see it, okay? Because they want to see the top 10 rods for, you know, picking up eel in that sense, yeah, okay? So what's interesting about this, the way this works and why it works so well is when someone's on desktop, it's easily digestible because you don't have this big chunk or long text. It's easy naturally to come in and read this short text because it's very short and easy, even though it's not short, but it appears so because the image is stacked on the right. So I always, 90% of the time on my buyer content, I will use a small image on the right-hand side and set it to medium on WordPress Gutenberg, okay? Then the next thing is after this, I will have it on the you know, buyer's guide. I'll have my buyer's guide. I might have a few images there. Again, only these small ones. Then before crossing over from the buyer's guide to this stuff here, this all this in-depth buyer reviews, I'll have a nice big full image, full width, okay? Nice big one, maybe like 900 pixels by 600 pixels, all right? Then as I come down on each of the reviews, I'll have a product review. Now, what's interesting is I think they do this bad, yeah, on this bit. Now, it's not bad because the site's so profitable, but I wouldn't, for this niche, it's okay. But what I do is you never want your featured image or this image up here to be just the product. You want to have it so someone's using the product. So when someone lands on this page, if it's a fishing rod, have a man in a boat fishing, okay, with that rod or with a rod. So someone can see, okay, well, this is going to tell me, like they can picture themselves. Because along with this, if everyone enjoys flying a drone, if they saw someone flying a drone, you can now put that picture and it brings that image more clarity when you're actually, you know, trying to sell someone on the product. Them seeing just the product is not that good, okay? They down when they're about to buy it, then yes, them seeing the product is great. All right, so at this point I would have this, I would have this, and then as I said, I would have a small conclusion and then the buy now button. Now the buy now button, I use the exact same text, okay? Click here to view now, a view on Amazon, and I use the exact same colors, this red and this orange, when they hover over. And then in Gutenberg, you can save it as a reusable block. So you don't have to create in this button. You can save it as a reusable block. You just click the three dots on Gutenberg and you can save the actual block. All right. Now, what I do differently is I've set this to full width. I didn't used to do that. Recently, I've just changed it because now I'm using Acabadu and it didn't look right with these small buttons. So now I've got the full width button. All right. And I just follow that same system. If I see anything that's really beneficial, I'll highlight it in yellow. Yeah, and on Gutenberg, that's really easy to do. Sometimes I'll have a little writing here, like check price on Amazon, so they can click over there, but you don't really need that. I find that without being pushy, people still click the buttons if they want to go check it out. And as long as your content's good, in-depth, well-researched, then people will feel no way to click your buttons and go check the product out. All right, so I hope this helped you. Honestly, I tried to go as in-depth as I can with this. I didn't want to go on the backlink stuff. And then you always want to put another table, by the way, at the bottom. So they usually have the 10 at the top. And I don't always do 10. Like, I think 10 is too much. Like, for people, it confuses them. They don't know what to buy. So maybe shorten it to, like, top 5, okay, if you're doing a buyer's review, okay? And don't do this on, like, you know, like, drone 4, 5, 8 review, because they don't want to see a list on that review. They just want to see a product review. You only do this on best buy articles because people are looking for a comparison, okay? And this is a comparison table. I personally recommend you use only 5 when you set this up, okay? I'll do a tutorial on setting up AAWP anyway in a future video. And then use 5 at the bottom as well. So for people who scroll all the way to the bottom, you want 5 there as well, okay? And that's it. That is it in a nutshell. You don't have to have comments. You can, if you want, enable them. I don't have them enabled at the moment. I used to, but I don't anymore. And yeah, just like follow the same structure. If you want to see this structure in detail, then head over to the guy's site, nichepie.com. He just done a new blog post after like 4 years or something that he's coming back and building another site. So yeah, go check it out. I hope you loved this video. If you did, make sure that you leave a like on this video. If you are new to the channel, make sure to subscribe. And I'll see you in the next one. Leave any questions or in the comment section, and I'll aim to get back to all of you within 24 hours. Peace. And I'll speak to you soon.